everyone. Welcome to another edition of Real Talk with Eileen Maher. I am Eileen Maher. On my left is frequent co-host Matt Bernstein. And we're here to talk about the post-Oscars show. Matt is gracious enough to come on every year. We kind of make some predictions.
My pleasure.
This year we really didn't. We just kind of chit-chatted about all the different films because we hadn't seen a lot.
Right.
And now we'll talk a little bit about the show, what we liked, what we didn't like. So let's get right to it. Beer of the show, beer of the month, is a beer called... Brewer's Pose. You know that pose where they pick up the glass and the light shines through. And that's basically, I'm reading from the can. You've seen it, the commercial with an overalled bearded brewer holds the glass, right? So, Shoveltown Brewery created Brewer's Pose, a Kolsch style ale that is really nice. So we are filming on Tuesday night, and today I think the temperature reached almost 60. It was a beautiful bike ride home from work. Absolutely lovely. So I'm kind of moving away from the heavy porters and the heavier beers I tend to drink during the winter, although I'll always drink a Guinness anytime, any day.
Knife and fork.
Yeah. It's nice because it's not too heavy, 5.2% alcohol by volume. It's a beautiful golden color. Matt and I both tried it and we both liked it.
Yeah,
so I can
really
highly recommend Shoveltown Brewery, Brewer's Pose, Kolsch style ale. And I did... Where did I pick this up? Oh, I got it at Milton Marketplace last night. You know, one of those trips where you just have to run into CVS for something real quick.
Yeah.
But then you're drawn over to Milton Marketplace.
There's that shelf, and you always see things you've never seen before, right?
Yes, it's true. They always have beers you've never seen before, and then they always have cookies, and, you know, it's a trip I always shouldn't make hungry, but I'm always hungry.
Beer and cookies, can't go wrong.
And you always come out loving everything I've gotten. All right, we're going to talk about the 95th Oscars. Wow, 95 years, huh? Jimmy Kimmel hosted for the third time. He hosted in 2012, 2018, and now 2023. A little bit in between there was Ricky Gervais, who I loved. Boy, do I like him poking fun
at it. He takes no prisoners, right?
Yes. Yeah. I missed him, and I'll have to say, as you know, and anybody that's watched the show, it's like 15, 16 years now that we've been doing this.
Right?
I really don't like watching the Academy Awards. I always have to work on Monday. I rarely see the show in live time. I might watch an hour, hour and a half, but I have to go to bed by 9 o'clock. I'm up at 4:45 in the morning, and I have a very physical, very, you know, like you, a very brain-demanding
job.
Sure,
absolutely.
So I got to watch the show on Hulu a couple of days after, in its entirety at my own leisure, so I could get up and do what I needed to do.
It's a good way to do it.
It is for me.
I mean, you know, we watched it all straight through on Sunday night, but it's then when it's over, you're just thinking, why did I sit through this? And I say that, I ask myself that question every year, and I come back every year because it's an obsession. I can't turn away.
And it's funny you say that because I keep saying every year, I've got to remember to request Monday off
and have
a little potty here. Or I believe the Brattle still has their Oscar show potty. That would be fun.
Yeah.
Because I think I'd enjoy it a whole lot more if I wasn't thinking, oh, it's 7 hours till I have to get up. Oh, it's 6 hours till I have to get up.
Yep.
So again, Jimmy Kimmel, not one of my favorite people. I don't think he's very... I don't like his show. I don't think he's very funny. I think he's kind of likable. He's a okay guy.
He's pretty likable. And
yeah.
I like his humor. I mean, I don't watch his show.
Yeah.
I tend not to watch those shows. But, I just think he's just this kind of this very relaxed style of humor. And,
yes.
And a lot of the jokes land. But there are some things on that night that, like when he pulled the donkey out.
Yes.
There were two low points, and that was one of them.
Yes. We'll definitely get to that because I have the highlight.
Oh, yeah. That was a low light.
So anyway, he comes out, he parachutes in. Goofy. And
right.
I think I've made the point a couple of years now that I just wish we could just have just a speck of class. You know, the Golden Globes is kind of funny and silly and, I just wish it was just, and I'm not saying it has to be boring or not with humor, but it's just kind of got, I think it's devolved into a more baser show than it should be, because I have great reverence for the Oscars and the films that are up for awards and the movies and the songs and everything. So again, I saw it and I didn't love it, just like you.
I think I probably enjoyed it more than you did.
You always do.
Well, it was also after last year, I felt like it was a good, although last year was a good step up. I mean, it was shocking. You know, everybody was talking about the slap.
Yeah.
But last year, they sort of found their bearings again after the pandemic year.
Yes.
Where, you know, last year they really showed a lot more clips. They really celebrated the art of the movies. And this year, I think they did a lot of the same.
Yeah.
You know?
And it's good because I think a lot of people don't see a lot, especially these films. A lot mm-hmm. of people don't see these films. These are right. not widely released. They're not huge fan favorites, shall mm-hmm. I say.
Right.
But it gets people interested in maybe something they would now potentially
right?
see. And
absolutely.
The more clips you can show, the better.
Yeah.
So let's talk about Jimmy Kimmel and what he did. Speak about what you were just saying about
Little
Donkey.
All right.
Jenny.
Banshee's a miniature.
A mule.
And,
he's a mule, actually, not a donkey. Oh, is he a donkey or a mule? I forget. I think he's a mule.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, So the animal from, and it wasn't even the one, but it was one, it was
right,
a local, you know, Hollywood animal. Fortunately, they didn't fly it in from somewhere, but, you know.
Oh, no, they flew it in on Spirit, isn't that what he said?
Oh, yeah,
yes.
That was the joke. Right.
Yeah.
But, so the Banshees of Inisherin, and, you know, the character, Colin Farrell's character, I mean, a companion is his prized donkey who comes into their cottage and everything. So, you know, in the Oscars, the host is always making a nod to one this movie or that movie.
Yeah.
But he drags this poor animal head on stage.
Yeah.
And I will accept a lot that's really in poor taste. I'm proud of that.
Yes.
But I just thought that animal did not look like it was happy to be there. And
no.
I just felt bad for the animal.
Yes, it was all bedecked and dressed up for the red carpet.
Or
it wasn't a red carpet this year.
Oh, no. I guess it was a gold or something. Was that what it was?
Come on. If you're going to change something, that's what you're going to change. and then what I found the absolute most cringeworthy was he goes into the audience and starts questioning people, and poor Malala was completely caught off guard.
Oh, yeah.
Didn't know what in the world he was talking about.
And it was really amazing.
It was awful. Mm-hmm.
But she handled it well.
She
stayed on point, on message for her message.
Yes.
And she rose above it. But it was, you saw him going over to her and it was like, no, don't.
Wrong,
don't.
Wrong. Wrong choice.
I know. He does it twice.
Yeah.
Yeah. But other than that, I thought that his most of the jokes landed pretty well.
Yeah.
And, you know, he stayed out of the way when he needed to stay out of the way. And I think he did a decent job on the
I guess, you know, and I know Robert Blake and the In Memoriam and, you know, hey, Robert Blake was acquitted. Robert Blake was acquitted, isn't that right?
That's absolutely right.
He died. He should be an In Memoriam. Let's just leave it at that, right?
Oh, and that was did you have this on your list? Can I say something about the In Memoriam
Please
segment?
Please do.
All right. So they do this In Memoriam segment.
Yes.
And you see, you know, a lot of the people that you expect to see and mm-hmm. some people you've never heard of. But it's mm-hmm. also, you know, all these people who did all these various things in the industry. And at the end, and they do this throughout the night, you know, go to this QR code to learn more. But this one was for a list, you know, to see more people who we lost in 2000, in this year, you know, and everybody, and I guess I had the same feeling that everyone then did very soon after it online, where they said, in other words, to see people we didn't think were important enough to mention on the, you know, on the award show, go, mm-hmm. and it was an offense to everybody who died who wasn't included.
Yes,
they also died.
Yeah, they also died. Oh my goodness. Anyway, and of course we had Cocaine Bear running around.
Oh
in
yeah,
the
yeah,
world,
including toward Malala, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
That was just bizarre. Anyway, that's what it is. That's what the Oscars has.
And that's product placement because that's a movie
you're
that's out now, right? Yeah.
But then. Anyway, we won't get into it. But you're right. It's 100% product placement. Let's just talk quickly about the winners. Okay?
Yeah.
So Best Picture, Everything Everywhere All at Once. Did you saw it?
I did.
You liked it? You didn't like it?
I liked it, and I can't wait to see it again.
Okay,
I've
a lot
waiting
of people
for the
say
time
that.
To do that, because I just feel like it's one of those movies that made me drowsy when I first watched it. There's just so much
point.
They're throwing at you. And, and I just felt like I wasn't prepared for it. And I have a feeling that I would like it a lot. I could be wrong, but I have a feeling I would like it a lot more if I saw it a second time.
Well, you made a great point because Tom saw it on a Friday night when I had already gone to bed. And Saturday I got up and said, I think it was a rainy Saturday. I said, what should we do? He goes, I saw this crazy movie last night, but I need to see it again. Would you watch this? And I'm like, sure. And of course I look and it's like almost 3 hours long. And I said, put it on. And I lasted an hour and a half. But Tom enjoyed it even more the second time around. So that is
that
something
too.
That we've heard.
Yeah.
Everything Everywhere All at Once, Best Picture. And it actually won seven Oscars for all different things. So, and big we'll go to the next one. The director, best director, were the Daniels. Mm-hmm. Daniel Kwan and Daniel Scheinert for Everything Everywhere All at Once.
Graduates of Emerson College.
Oh, wow. Yeah. I didn't know that.
A nice local angle. And, you know, they're just, throughout the night, their speeches, the energy, it was very generous, very good.
Yes. Remember who they thanked?
Oh, gosh.
Thank a teacher. Right. It was the two of them. Thank a teacher. And I thought, it's so wonderful to hear, you know. So many teachers make such a difference in young people's lives.
Absolutely.
You know, and don't ever get the credit that they deserve.
That's for sure.
Leading actor. Oh, this one caught me off guard. Brendan Fraser for The Whale. Have you seen it?
I have not seen it, and I still predicted that he would win. I mean, I made my predictions just the night, night before.
I predicted Austin Butler.
Who a lot of people have predicted. Yeah. Absolutely. And I just had the feeling that this was going to be, I think that there was something about Brendan Fraser and his comeback that I just think.
Blah, blah.
I know. I think that Hollywood's, but I'm, you know, the verdict's out for me until I actually see the movie.
Well, I did get a chance to see it.
Did you?
And I was completely underwhelmed.
Oh, yeah.
But we'll get to that another time because I think we need one more show.
Okay.
Where we come on, we can really talk about not only the films that we've seen, the films that we both love that did not win, the films that were nominated.
Oh, that would be great.
We saw a lot of things.
I'd love to do that.
All right, so that'll be the follow-up to this.
None of which we agreed on. Anyway,
no, which
right?
is really
but it'd be good. Yeah.
Yes, it's really, really good. So God bless Brendan Fraser. I love him. I loved the Mummy films. Gods and Monsters. Woo!
Terrific performance.
You've got to
see
good
that. Movie. Yeah.
This?
Really?
Meh.
Okay. Yeah, and most people, there were very few people who were hot on that movie.
Yeah.
And they just said that he was his performance was maybe the only thing about it that was very good.
Yes.
But I'd be very interested to catch up with it. Yeah.
Leading actress was won by Michelle Yeoh for Everything Everywhere All at Once. Again, a favorite. Mm-hmm. I do believe she was pretty much favorite. I picked Kate Blanchett from Tar because, boy, what a performance she gave.
Oh, it's a great performance.
But Michelle Yeoh was phenomenal, too.
She was.
And Tom and I bet... not yet, but, you know, we both had our little Vanity Fair ballots. And he says he meant to pick Michelle Yeoh, but he picked Michelle Williams. So I don't know. Should I give it to him? Should I not?
It's like the Daniels, the Michelles.
Yes. Yeah, she was phenomenal.
Very good.
She had to really
fly through all those different tones of that movie. And ground the movie. She's the center of it. So, she does all that. And she's been in the business for so long.
So
it's great to see her on the stage, accepting that award.
Absolutely. Especially for older people everywhere. God bless her. She can still move. She's 60, God
bless
her. Amazing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Excuse me. On to supporting actor. Ki-Hu Kwan, right?
Right. For Everything Everywhere All at Once.
And speak to him a little bit. What's his past?
So he was in Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom, and he was the boy on the Short Round, I think was the name of the character he played with Harrison Ford, and he's so child actor, been in the business for a long time, had long fallow periods in the business, not a lot of great roles for Asian actors, which is another reason why somebody like Michelle Yeoh winning Best Actress is really a notable achievement. And same for Kwan, Ki-Hu Kwan, who also, as I think everybody in that movie had to sort of fulfill a lot of different tones and sort of nail them and keep the audience grounded. And he does that too. He's like a heart and soul of that movie in a lot of ways. And his speech was, a number of speeches that I found very moving and very heartfelt. And his, maybe one, was most of all.
Thanks his wife.
Oh yeah.
His parents.
Right.
He was born in Vietnam as well, I believe, right? Was it Vietnam?
I'm not sure.
Vietnam,
I think so too.
This is the American dream.
Right.
It was lovely to hear. And he's just so exuberant and full of life.
Yes.
And as he was in the film, and if you haven't seen Everything Everywhere, I just call it EEAAO.
There you go.
He's just the guy.
Yeah.
He's the guy who convinces the girl, come with me to America, come with me to America.
Right.
And they open up this crappy laundromat that never gets any better. And she pretty much holds down the fort.
Right.
But he's just a good guy.
It's a love story. It's
it
a very heartwarming movie.
It is a
And that's the other thing
story.
About this movie, I think, that really stuck with voters probably and maybe with audiences too. It's the year of the feel bad movies. So many of the movies that were up for awards this year are about, you know, really grim topics with grim themes.
Yeah.
Make you, you know,
jeez, feel, well, what do you have? We have war. Right? We have war. Avatar's about war. Yeah.
Women Banshees, talking. Is
oh,
all of,
woman.
You know,
to, oh, right, God. You know, Banshees of Inisherin, you know, friendship broken.
Yeah, absolutely.
Elvis, you know, rising star.
Betrayal,
you know,
and all that.
Oh,
so everything everywhere all at once.
You're
was,
right.
You know,
looking
I mean,
at
gave,
it.
Yeah,
oh
gave people
gosh.
A lot of hope. Plus, it was just so original.
It was. It was very, very, very original.
Yeah.
Okay, on to the next. Is in. I'm just going to switch up a little bit. International feature.
Oh, yeah.
So the nominees were All Quiet on the Western Front, Argentina 1985, Close from Belgium, EO from Poland, and Quiet Girl from Ireland, and All Quiet on the Western Front won. Mm-hmm. And I'm glad. It had to win something. I did feel it had to win something, even though it was not a favorite of mine.
And I liked it very much.
I liked it.
I found
it
really moving, and I just thought it was just so artfully made.
It was artfully
so,
made.
So, you know, I mean, Everything Everywhere All at Once, you said it won 7 awards for the
yeah,
night.
Yeah, yeah.
All Quiet on the Western Front, I think won 3 or 4.
Yeah,
so I
it
think
won
it
a
had,
good couple. Did,
so it had a really good night, cinematography.
Yes, I think
you know,
music
things.
Was it original?
Oh, the score as
yes,
well.
Yes, original score,
yeah.
which was so. You saw it. I mean, right from the beginning, it's like. Dun, dun. You
yeah,
can almost
two
you
notes.
Can feel it.
Yes, you
can you feel
do.
It. You know what it's like? Dun, 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 dun. It's just
oh,
like Jaws, right? It's very visceral, and you
it
almost
is.
You almost feel it. Vibrate in your heart.
That's right. That's right.
And you know, that's a film that when I saw it, I didn't love it. But then it's nice to have time to let a film sit.
For sure.
Because I liked it more and more. I found myself thinking about it more and more as the days
I
went
did too.
On.
A lot of the imagery and the
yes.
relationships with the soldiers, you know, among the soldiers and just,
yes.
you know, people said, oh, it's just this war film and it's just carnage after carnage, but it's so much more than
yes,
that.
Yes, it is.
I thought it was very well made. So
it was.
I was happy to see, like you, I was really happy to
and
see
I
it.
And I think, I don't know if we talked about it last time, but last time I said, I didn't even like it, but I've changed my mind.
Oh, you
know? And that's the beauty of time. And a good film will sit with you and evolve.
Oh, yeah.
That's why I remember years ago when I used to do the show, I'd go out and I'd see a bunch of films. And it might take me 2 or 3 weeks to do a show. And it would really be kind of nice. Like, I feel bad for the reviewers that have to go out, see a show in the morning, and write up their review that night. And it gets printed in the paper the next day. Because a film really needs to sit. It needs to sit and marinate.
Oh,
almost,
absolutely.
You know?
No, for sure.
And that's one that really has for
yeah.
me. The lead actor in that was just, the more I think about him, he was just phenomenal.
And it was his first film.
Really?
When they get up on stage, the director, you know, was thanking him. And he said, you know, this guy, there's no movie without him. And, you know, it was just, he was good casting. And it was,
yes.
you know, it's amazing. Who, the people who can just step up and take that stage
yes,
on, you know.
Absolutely.
As actors.
Next, best song. I thought we'd talk a little bit about that because that was the most beautiful acceptance speech. Best song was from a film called RRR, which I've got to see.
I've heard it's really good. I'd like to see it
yes,
as well. It's on my
it's
list.
Three plus hours.
Long.
So I
yeah.
said we'll watch that on the weekend, maybe an hour and a half on Saturday, an hour and a half on Sunday. But it won for best song called Natu Natu. And I loved the acceptance speech by the composer.
Mm.
I know I wrote his name down somewhere. Anywho, he basically said, you know what? And he's an Indian gentleman, and he talks about his love of the Carpenters. And he gave his acceptance speech in like the tune of a Carpenters song.
Close
and it was
to
just
you, I think, right?
Close to you,
yeah.
absolutely.
Yeah, it was,
and
yeah, it was charming.
It was so wonderful.
It was.
And it's one of the songs I used to sing to the kids in bed at night.
Oh,
when
do
birds
nice.
Suddenly appear? Just like me, they long to be close to you. When
he
starts singing, I'm like,
that.
Oh,
that's
yeah,
really,
my God,
that's
so
wonderful.
Beautiful.
That must
and
have
was just,
really hit you.
And
right
he
here.
Was so happy. He was just so, again, some of these people who get these awards are just so happy.
Oh, yeah.
And he was so happy. It was
well,
which
also
lovely.
Brings us to some of the way that they cut people off when they take.
Oh, we've got to talk about
crazy?
That.
Well, because
look
it's
at
also
this.
Really inconsistent.
Need to do a better job of timing acceptance speeches of awards with multiple
okay.
winners.
I am with you completely, especially
holy moly.
Because they're not consistent with it.
They're not consistent.
And,
at all.
You know, there were some people who just seemed like they let them go on. You know, the first person, it's, and they're usually the.
The lead person yeah, talks a little,
and they're not top awards. You know, there might be like,
yes,
you know,
yes, yes.
I mean, just this, you know, production or something. It's
yes.
you know, sometimes it can be, you know, documentary short subject,
yes.
whatever. There are four people on the stage, or three, and they're
yeah.
all holding an Oscar, and
yeah.
everybody should at least get a chance to say
you're
thank
right.
you. Just have their
you're
voice on the microphone.
I think but you and I need to do this show next year. I'm telling you, I would run this thing.
Oh my
and
God.
It would be,
move
it would be
along,
the
right?
Forget the Super Bowl.
Right.
This show would be watched by
and it also just seemed like people of color were the ones who were
people.
Cut off. And
really?
Yeah,
interesting.
I don't know why.
Interesting.
But they were cut off. The mm-hmm. orchestra came up. One woman was still shouting at the microphone. You could see her just trying to
yeah.
say, like, I'm not leaving, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah,
yeah
they
it's
have
really
to do a better
poorly
job
done. Really, you should just say, okay, everybody line up, hold
right.
your ass. You got 30 seconds, go. You got 30 seconds,
right,
go.
Right.
Whatever
but,
it is, let us know ahead of time.
Yeah.
And we will plan our 30 seconds.
I know.
Yeah. It was
I thought
just seemed to be really like.
If I were one of those people who had to share an Oscar with two other people,
yeah.
we would work our speech so that we would have like one word, next word.
I like
it. Wouldn't that be, that would
yeah,
be clever.
Would be
and then
cool.
they couldn't push
I
you
think
off.
We should definitely be doing it, running the show next year. I also had to mention animated feature, Guillermo del Toro's Pinocchio 1. Did you get a chance to see
it? No, but
you
I know
must.
You like that very
I
much.
Really
I
did.
Would like to catch
Please
up with
see
that,
and I'm
sure.
so glad that it won it. Especially, I do believe it was a true labor of love. It's that stop action animation where it takes 5 years to make, 5 minutes of film. Of course,
and he said something that was very powerful. He just, when he got up, del Toro, he said, animation is cinema. He just underlined that. He just basically said it's not some side, sort of form of film. It is cinema itself.
Yes.
And people just have to note that and recognize it.
Yes. So yeah. I loved that. And I'm also just going to mention, we did not talk about supporting actress.
Oh, we got to do that.
Oh, Jamie Lee Curtis. Again, Everything, Everywhere, All at Once. And
right.
she plays a...
She plays the IRS, the audit accountant.
Yes,
yeah,
and,
brutal.
She was so brutal. And like
tough,
her appearance.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And Jamie's a beautiful older woman, and I love her because she's always talking about how important it is to age gracefully
right?
and forget about these, what do they call them, pharmaceuticals, where you're injecting yourself
oh, yeah.
and you're trying to make yourself something that you're not.
She
and her hair
great.
Is beautiful
totally
and great.
Real.
Yeah. She's still fit. And her love for Christopher Guest, her
oh, yeah,
husband,
great,
the two
long
of them.
Long-time couple, right?
Have
they're both
ever
so talented.
Done a film together?
Oh, gosh, I wonder. That I would.
Think
that's
they
a movie
have.
I would definitely see.
I know.
Can you imagine the kind of thing that they
it
would put
would
together?
Be amazing.
But I was happy to see her win. It was maybe the closest thing to an upset for the night.
Yes.
Angela,
who
because
well,
I think Angela Bassett was definitely in the running as a possibility.
Yes, I believe that Tom picked her actually.
Yeah.
But he was wrong.
Well, I did too.
I know
I
that people
wrong.
Were very upset.
Including Angela Bassett, who was shown on screen sort of scowling
that's
and not
just
clapping.
Not nice, you know?
But, so it was not the greatest moment for her. We did see Black Panther Wakanda Forever
yes.
just maybe the day before the Oscars, and she's phenomenal in it.
No
I
question.
Mean, I thought that,
So was she a supporting
she
actress or was she a leading actress?
Oh, no, she's definitely a supporting actress, but it was, she, Regal, she was the queen. She had a power, she had a powerful role and she played it powerfully.
Yes.
But, nothing was going to get out of the way of everything all.
You're right,
once.
You're
it
right.
Was, it's night, basically. And Jennifer,
Jamie
Lee Curtis. I mean, she's been a lifer. She's been around forever. She, in her speech, she even
yes.
said,
yes.
All those years doing genre pictures,
you
know, being
it.
A scream queen,
yes.
doing Halloween 6,
yes,
it's
yes.
like, that's still movie making.
And she
man,
also,
you know?
What did she call it? A nepotic award.
Oh, right,
because
the Nepo
of
baby.
Mom and Dad, right?
Right? Yeah,
because
yes,
of Jamie Lee Curtis's
right.
mom was
so much of that.
Janet Leigh.
Janet Leigh
and
from
Dad
Psycho.
Is Tony Curtis.
Right.
And they've both been awarded.
They were both
awarded, but at least
nominated. Yep.
She understands. She realizes,
and
she was just so happy. You saw again her. I won an Oscar.
She really
just
felt
lovely.
It. It was a great
and,
moment.
Speaking of Angela Bassett, I coached. I was blessed to coach softball here in town, and we were the Bad News Bears. We were not the best team, but every now and then we'd win, and I would always just say to the girls, "Congratulate whoever wins."
Yeah.
Be happy, be a good winner,
right?
And be a good loser.
Oh,
because there's only two choices. You're going to win this award, you're going to lose it.
Right.
There's, besides you, there's four other people up for it. You've only got a 20% chance of, it's all somewhere. But you know what I mean? Be prepared to lose.
Be prepared to lose, yeah.
And, and that's okay.
Yeah.
Again, so many people get up there and say, I want to thank my fellow nominees.
Oh, yeah, it's such an honor to be nominated. It's like, go.
But I got
it.
Yeah. All right, what else did I want to just mention? Because we're running short on
running.
Time.
Yeah.
Oh, just some really cool moments in the acceptance speeches. I don't know if you've seen the documentary, Navalny.
Oh, that was a power. I haven't.
Incredible documentary, and the whole family coming on stage. Yep. That was his wife and his two children were there. And I recommend that film to anyone. It's only like, again, about an hour and a half, and it tells the story of a Russian nationalist who is, you know, bucking the trends of Vladimir Putin. And
still,
of course,
in prison.
He's in jail. Yeah. What do you expect, right? Well, they tried to poison him, and that didn't happen. So absolutely see that.
Yeah.
I loved that acceptance speech. And then I also loved, for live action short, an Irish goodbye one. And they had the cast come up and sing happy birthday to one of the cast members.
I did like that too. That was a great moment.
Wow, was that a heartfelt moment?
Right. And they had everybody else singing it in the audience.
Yes,
that was a very, very authentic moment for everyone.
And then probably my next favorite acceptance speech was... James Friend, who won for cinematographer.
Oh, I like that too.
Yes, for All Quiet on the Western Front.
Right.
He's just like, me?
Right.
You know, he's just like, me?
Yep.
It's just only the second film he's ever been involved in as a cinematographer. And I liked how he has come up through the ranks. He was actually, an on-set electrician.
Before
somebody
else who was nominated. For, yeah.
I mean, I love those ascension
those are great
stories
moments.
Because that doesn't happen a lot. I don't know what your job is like, but in my job, it used to be you start here and then you work here and here and here, and then the person at the top knows everything about everything.
Right.
And that's just not the way it is. All right, Tom says we have 2 minutes to go.
The other moment that I found very funny was Hugh Grant and Annie McDowell. Hugh Grant had, I don't know if you know, we'll repeat it here, but you can easily Google it. But his, he got up to present with Andy McDowell. They were together, you know, they were together in 4 weddings and a funeral. Some time has passed.
Mm-hmm.
And he was very funny.
Yeah, and a bit
off color.
Feeling a bit peckish, aren't we? Yes. All right, anyway, thank you so much for joining us. Matt and I are going to get together for one more show, Academy Awards, just to talk about the films that we saw that maybe were nominated but didn't win, but we loved. Honestly, the films that I loved the most this year did not win. So get out there, see any of these films, see any films. Support your local community theaters, especially Dedham Community.
And that's what I was just going to say. Yep.
Love it.
Get
you
out
saw
there.
A great film there. And John Wick 4 is coming to Dedham Community Theater this Friday.
Really? Oh, man. That does not sound like a Dedham Community Theater
That's what I said. Get out there and see some films. Thanks so much.
Thanks for having me. Always fun.
Matt.